Operations Coordinator and Narrator for Team Oracle, featuring the man considered by many to be the top solo aerobatic performer in North America today. Coming all the way from Salinas, California, in that very small, bright red, custom-built biplane known as the hardcore, down and dirty, hard charging, power aerobatics, known to man, which come as a result of Sean's more than 20,000 hours of combined fixed wing and rotary wing flight time. This aircraft is all new. Spiraling tower, watch as he shot, stops it now. Now on the descending line, the quick half roll to upright. Another quick half roll to upright begins the hooey loop. This is an inside outside loop with a tumble at the top. The first half is inside, or what we call positive G's. The second over six negative G's, trying to throw Sean out of the cockpit at the bottom end of that last maneuver. This aircraft made its maiden flight in the middle of March after having spent 18 months of construction. It weighs in at barely 1,225 pounds, and it is powered by more than 400 horsepower, making it without question the world today. As you can imagine, this style of flying is very athletic and very hard on the body. Throughout the course of one performance, Sean will experience in excess of 10 and a half positive G's and over 7 and a half negative G's. So as you catch his breath, tighten up his seatbelts and let those engine temperatures cool down. Vertical, a full roll followed by the shoulder roll. Zero forward airspeed and hard full left rudder. It is Sean's double hammerhead. Accelerating straight towards the that stick forward. Another high negative G. Inverted recovery takes him away from the crowd. Our air show season began in the middle of April at Andrews Air Force Base in Washington, D.C. After a total of 19 events during the 2010 air show season, we will continue in November in Fort Worth, Texas. In that time, in front of more than 8 million air show fans. Climb for some altitude. Catch his breath, tighten up his seat belts, and let those engine temperatures cool down. So while Sean
yeah, baby. Oh, thank God. sky and then he started flying backwards tail first. Go control for all the controls in reverse. Keep going back, farther, 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 farther. Keep flying by, he said. So I win it, he said, you got this.
Stand 20 feet above the ground, and they are spaced 700 feet apart. Miles an hour, 5 feet above the ground. He is going to go underneath the ribbon of the six positive G's and triple avalanche. And he's going to stop right now. Continuing his way around the corner. What he's doing is verifying that the Chola is obstruction free. Because what Sean is now dive down and attempt to slice all three of those ribbons in one single pass in three separate flight attitudes. Right knife edge, left knife edge, and finally inverted. But first, from the right, watch closely. Sean is going to demonstrate for you the world's smallest. Low-speed photo pass.
Hey, yeah, baby! Okay, the little girl in the pink dress. Give me a wave! You got that right, everybody! God bless America! Okay, everybody, this is the Sports Squadron. What do you think of them? Let's have a big round of applause for the Brazilian Sports Squadron! Yeah, baby! Ladies and gentlemen, showing you why he is considered to be one of the very best of all
Just 4 years ago, Sean was honored by the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum as being one of the 25 living legends. We've had a wonderful time here in Portsmouth, and we invite you to look us up online at teamoracle.com, and also please visit Sean's Facebook fan page. That is Sean D. Tucker. Sean Tucker, and he spells the first name S-E-A-N. Now, let's turn things back over to Howie.
That's our nice round of applause for Brian Norris. I hear the same from Brian. Great job again, as you look for next time, man.